Good morning, students. Till now, we have discussed active and passive voice rules for simple present, simple past, simple future, and continuous tense. Now, in this video, we will discuss the rules for perfect tense as well as we will discuss some miscellaneous rules of active and passive voice. Before beginning with the rules of perfect tense, we will revise the previous rules. If your active voice is given in simple present tense, then in passive voice, we will use helping verbs is, am or are followed by past participle. If your active voice is given in simple past, then we will use helping verbs was or were followed by past participle. Similarly, if your active voice is given in simple future tense, then one word will be added, that is be. Will change into will be and shall will change into shall be followed by past participle. In case your active voice is given in continuous tense, then V1 plus ing will change into being followed by past participle. And there is no passive form of future continuous tense. Now we will discuss the rules of perfect tense for active and passive voice. Now we will discuss the last type. If your active voice is given in present, past or future perfect, then while changing it into passive voice, we have to add the word been after your has, have or had. Now, in the first sentence, first of all, again, we are going to identify our subject, verb and object. Raj has eaten an ice cream. Who Raj? Subject, single underline. Has eaten, action word, double underline. What an ice cream? Triple underline. Now, here also an ice cream will come in the beginning. Raj will go to the last. Eaten is already given in its past participle form. It will remain same. After has, we will add the word been. So our sentence will become an ice cream has been eaten by Raj. Full stop at the end. Similarly, in the second sentence, we will underline subject, verb and object. Children, subject, single underline. Had played, verb, double underline. Football, object, triple underline. So our sentence will become football, had, after had, we have to add the word be. Football had been played by children. At the end, full stop. Now we'll do the last sentence. Raj will have eaten an ice cream. Who? Raj, subject, single underline. Action word, will have eaten, double underline. What? An ice cream, triple underline. After have, we have to add the word been. An ice cream will come in the beginning. An ice cream will have been eaten by Raj. Add that, full stop. We are going to discuss now some miscellaneous rules of active and passive voice. If active voice is given in negative form, it will remain negative in passive also. We will understand this with the help of example. The first example, I do not like her. I, subject, single underline. Do not like, verb, double underline. Her, object, triple underline. Her will come in the beginning. It will become she. I will go to the last. It will become me. Like will change into liked. Before me, we have to add the word by. Now, do is present form of verb. Do and does change to is, am, are. So here, with she, we will use is. She is not liked by me. Active voice is also given in the negative. Passive is also given in the negative. Now, we will proceed to the second sentence. John, subject, single underline, did not eat, double underline, verb. Mango, object, triple underline. Mango will come in the beginning. John will go to the last. It will change into its past participle form eaten. Before John, we have to add the word by. Did is past form of verb, so we will use here either was or were. With mango, we will use was. So our sentence will become mango was not eaten by John. Another rule says, if the subject in the active voice is not very important, then we can omit it in passive voice. This means that if subject is not required, we can omit it in the passive voice. In the first sentence, somebody stole my purse. Somebody, subject, singular underline, stole, verb double underline, my purse, object, triple underline. My purse will come in the beginning. Stole will change into its past participle form, stolen. Stole is a past form of verb. V2 changes to was, were plus past participle. So here, we have to add one helping verb. My purse is singular, so we will add here was. My purse was stolen. This sentence is also correct. There is no requirement to write by somebody. Similarly, in the second sentence, somebody, subject, single underline, ate, verb double underline, the food, object, triple underline. The answer will become the food was eaten. We can omit the word somebody and the answers in this way are also correct. The next rule is very important. If active voice has verb which is followed by a preposition, then the preposition will come in the passive voice along with past participle form of verb. We will understand this rule with the help of example. The first example, a nurse looks after a patient. Here after is a preposition and it will come in the passive voice also after your verb. Now we have already underlined our subject, verb and object. We'll start with the explanation. A patient will come in the beginning. A nurse will go to last. Looks will change into looked. And after this, we have to write the preposition. Before our object, we have to write the word by. And looks is a present form of verb. So with patient, we will write here is. So our answer will become a patient is looked after by a nurse. Similarly, we'll do the second sentence here also. Jackets will come in the beginning. They will go to the last and it will become them. Shopping will change into shopped. After shopping, for is given as preposition. It will come in the passive form also. Now here, with jackets, we have to use helping verb. And were is given, which is used for plural. So we will use here were again. ing form is given, so we have to add the word being. So our sentence will become jackets were being shopped for by them. Now we will discuss some more examples of active and passive voice for perfect tense and miscellaneous rules. Raj has brought a table. Who Raj? Subject single underline. Has brought verb double underline. What a table triple underline. A table will come in the beginning. Raj will go to the last. Brought will remain brought. Before Raj we will add the word by. And has will change into has been. So our sentence will become a table has been brought by Raj. Full stop at the end. The second sentence. I had expected good news. Who I, so subject single underline, had expected verb double underline. What good news, object triple underline. Good news will come in the beginning. I will go to the last and it will become me. Expected will remain expected. Before me we will add the word by. Now had will change into had been. So, a sentence will become good news had been expected by me. The third sentence, India will have won this match. Who India? So, subject single underline. Action word will have won, verb double underline. What this match? Object triple underline. This match will come in the beginning. India will go to the last. One will remain one. Before India, we will add the word by. Will have will change to will have been. This match will have been won by India. Full stop. The fourth sentence. The police has beaten the thief. Who? The police. Subject single underline. Action word has beaten double underline. Whom? The thief. Object triple underline. The thief will come in the beginning. The police will go to the last. Beaten will remain beaten. Before the police, we will add the word by. Now here has will change into has been. So our sentence will become, the thief has been beaten by the police. Full stop at the end. The last sentence, Ria will have cooked the meal. Who Ria? So subject single underline. Will have cooked, action word, verb double underline. What? The meal. Object triple underline. The meal will come in the beginning. Ria will go to the last. Cooked will remain cooked. Before Ria, we will add the word by. Will have will change into will have been. So our sentence will become, the meal will have been cooked by Ria at the end. Full stop. Now these examples are related to your miscellaneous rules. Now the first example, you had not taken the dinner. Now this sentence in the active voice is given in the negative form. In the passive voice also it will remain negative. You subject single underline, had not taken verb double underline, the dinner object triple underline. So the dinner will come in the beginning. You will go to the last and it will remain you. After had, we have to add the word been. The answer will become, the dinner had not been taken by you. The next sentence, somebody stole the car. Here somebody is your subject, single underline. Stole, verb, double underline. What? The car, object, triple underline. As we have discussed the rule that if somebody is given as your subject, then you can omit it while writing your passive voice. So the answer will be, the car was stolen. If you will write by somebody, it would be also correct. But this is also the another way of writing the sentence. The eighth sentence. The doctor looked after the patient. Now, according to this, we have done that if the preposition is given in the active voice, then in the passive voice also the preposition will be having after your verb. Now, the patient will come in the beginning. The doctor will go to the last. Looked will remain looked. And after looked, we will add the word after. So our answer will become, the patient was looked. Looked is a past form of verb, so here we will use was. The patient was looked after by the doctor. Full stop. Ninth example. Ria has not eaten the food. Who? Ria, subject single underline. Has not eaten, verb double underline. What? The food, triple underline. So here the food will come in the beginning. Ria will go to the last. Eaten will remain eaten. Has not eaten will change into has not been eaten. The food has not been eaten by Ria. Full stop. The last sentence, someone knocked the door. Now in the same way we can omit this someone and the answer we can simply write, the door was knocked. Full stop at the end. I hope you all have understood the rules of active and passive voice. Now, following these rules, do related exercises of chapter 17, active and passive voice, from your basic English grammar and composition book. Thank you.